students, tomorrow we are going to write a test on transport in plants part 2, starting from how do plants absorb water to phloem transport from source to sink. So now I am going to briefly explain about how do plants absorb water. The main source of water is mainly the soil water. The absorbable form of water is mainly capillary water, which is absorbed by the root system. So in the root system, mainly one region, that is region of maturation or region of root hair, which has unicellular outgrowths called root hairs, are the main water absorbing structure. They absorb water and mineral nutrients present in the soil. So just briefly we will learn about the structure of the root hair. They are short, delicate, unicellular outgrowths formed by certain epiblema cells of the root, especially in case of dicot or all that. So this is the cell wall. This cell wall is having inner cellulose and outer pectin, which is hydrophilic colloidal substance which can absorb water from the soil. So this is the cytoplasm containing a large vacuole filled with cell sap, and here you have the nucleus. The length of this root hair is 1 mm to 1 cm in length, and the diameter of this root hair is 10 micron in diameter. So these are present around 2000 root hairs in 1 millimeter area of that root system. They are short-lived structures. So many of the transplanted seedlings cannot survive due to the damage to these root hairs. So surrounding of this root hair you have the capillary water, which is the readily absorbable form of water. Different forms of water are there, but this is a very useful form of water. So usually these root hairs will absorb the water. Initially there will be diffusion, then on the surface there can be imbibition, and finally through osmosis water can enter into the root hair. So water will enter into the root hair. After the entry of water into the root hair, this water has to reach the innermost part, outer cortical cells and inner cortical cells, and finally to the xylem of the root. So there are mainly two pathways by which water can reach the xylem of the root. This is the root hair, this is the epiblema, these cells are cortical cells made up of parenchyma, this is endodermis, this is pericycle, this is xylem. So after the absorption of water by the root hair, this water will reach the xylem mainly by two pathways. These pathways are, first one is apoplast pathway, second one symplast pathway. These two terms were coined by Ernst Munch, a German biologist. Apoplast, simple meaning non-living continuity. Symplast, simple meaning living continuity. The movement of water from one cell to another cell, finally reaching the xylem through non-living continuity. That non-living continuity is through the intercellular space and the cell wall. That is apoplast pathway. So there is no obstruction for the flow of water as non-living continuity is involved. So there will be bulk flow or mass flow of water from the root hair to the xylem along the water potential gradient. From higher water potential gradient to lower water potential gradient, water can very easily pass. Then simplest pathway, that is the movement of water from the root hair to the xylem, mainly involving the living cells, that is mainly passing through the plasmodesmata, passing through the cytoplasm and vacuole. So as it passes through the plasmodesmata, cytoplasm, including vacuole, so this is the simplest pathway. So there is obstruction for the movement of water mainly through the plasmodesmata, then through the tonoplast, which is covering the vacuole. The flow of water in the apoplast pathway is much faster compared to the simplest pathway. So this is how water can reach the xylem of the root system. There is another figure which is given in NCRT. This is the epidermal cell, this is the cortical cell, this is the endodermal cell, this is the pericycle cell, and here you have xylem. This is the endodermal cell. Endodermal cell has in the cell wall the Casparian thickening. This Casparian thickening is deposited with suberin, which is impermeable to water. So here, movement of water through plasmodesmata is shown like this, passing through the plasma membrane, then cytoplasm, then even it can pass through the vacuole. So the movement of water molecule from one cell to another cell through the plasmodesmata, through the cytoplasm, this is what you call simplest pathway. And another method, when the movement of water occurs through intercellular space and cell wall, is this is the apoplast pathway. In the case of apoplast pathway, further it cannot pass through the endodermis, as the endodermal wall is made up of Casparian thickening deposited suberin. Hence here it has to take the simplest pathway, and finally it has to reach the xylem. The simplest pathway can be aided by the cytoplasm extreme movement within the cell, as seen in the cells of the hydrilla. So bulk flow of water along the concentration gradient mainly occur through the non-living continuity, that is through apoplast pathway. Then how is the mechanism involved in absorption of water? So you have mainly two mechanisms. One is passive water absorption and another one active water absorption. These are the two mechanisms which are involved in absorption of water from the soil by the root. So 96% of the plants mainly absorb water from the soil by passive water absorption. In case of passive water absorption, the upper aerial parts of the plant, particularly leaves, are actively involved, which carry out active transpiration during daytime, and that results in the development of transpiration pull or the suction force, which is responsible for the passive absorption of water into the root hair, not by the root hair. So finally it takes the radial transport and reach the xylem of the root. So most of the trees, shrubs and many of the plants, they mainly absorb water by passive method, and small number of plants, around 4%, they absorb water mainly by active water absorption, which is seen mainly in small herbaceous plants, that is seen mainly during early hours of the morning or during night hours when there is no active transpiration. So in active water absorption, mainly the activity of the root cells is very much involved here. So the respiration in the root cells will result in the liberation of energy, metabolic energy in the form of ATP that can be used in the absorption of water. Active water absorption can occur either by osmotic active water absorption or by non-osmotic water absorption. Two methods are there. In osmotic water absorption, mainly along the osmotic concentration from higher, the surrounding soil has capillary water. So here, water potential is more, solute potential is less. And in the root air, water potential is less, solute potential is more. Hence, water from surrounding soil enters into the root air. So along the what you call osmotic potential, water enters from soil to the root air and from root air to outer cortical cells, inner cortical cells, and finally reach the what you call xylem. Here there is no expenditure of energy. Due to osmotic potential concentration gradient between the root and surrounding soil, there will be absorption of water. But in non-osmotic concentration, osmotic water absorption, there is expenditure of energy because again the concentration gradient, water has to be absorbed by the root air. So these are the two mechanisms which you can see in plants, but mainly by passive water absorption there will be bulk amount of water absorption in plants. In certain plants you can see symbiotic association in the roots. That symbiotic association you can call it as mycorrhiza. Mycorrhiza is a symbiotic association of the fungal mycelium with the roots of usually higher plants. Some of the plants they show the association of the fungal mycelium on the roots. This fungal mycelium can help in increasing the surface area of water and mineral nutrient absorption. So the fungus will help in absorption of water and mineral nutrients to the plants. It supplies the water and nutrients to the plant. At the same time, the plant which is autotrophic, it can supply the polysaccharide, nitrogen containing polysaccharide or carbohydrate, organic food to the fungal partner. Okay, so certain plants they have obligatory association with the mycorrhiza. Especially you take for example pinus. Pinus seeds cannot establish without mycorrhizal association. So this is a brief discussion about how do plants absorb water. Thank you.